Alright, so we just got here to Good Surf, met the whole crew, got a hat. Alright, pretty cool setup here with all the tables. We got the surf shop in there, restaurant, all this outdoor seating here, couches, lounge area, the pool.
Alright, so with me, I brought the brand new Aipa. It's a 5.3, an Aipa with the XTR. And I've never tried it before, so I'm definitely curious to see how it's gonna go. And then I also brought the trusty old 5.1 Aipa that I brought to Chelan and to Singapore. Been repaired a few times. This time was from Washington, and this time was from Singapore. And fixed the tail a few times as well. So, I'm gonna try them back to back and see how they go on the new wave.
Alright, so first I'm gonna try the original blue Aipa because it's a new wave and I wanna ride a board that I'm already comfortable with, a board I already know. So I can like figure out the wave first and see if there are any noticeable differences between this wave and any other waves. So straight away, right when I hopped on the yellow Aipa, I could feel a difference. I noticed that it was definitely longer and then it was definitely more buoyant than the blue Aipa. When I did my airs and tricks, there was a lot more stability and there was a lot more room for me to move my feet around and stay on the wave. With the blue Aipa, it's definitely sharper and more responsive. Definitely felt more like a knife, more like a blade cutting through the water. But I also had to be a lot more on my game and in tune with what was happening because like it's that much more responsive and sensitive that if I mess up or something then I'm gonna fall or I'll get kicked off the wave. But with the yellow one, it definitely was more forgiving, and the more that I ride it, the more it's growing on me, that's for sure. And for the amount that I rode the yellow one, I could tell that it's definitely a lot stronger than the regular blue polyester as well. Like for the amount that I rode the yellow one, the other blue polyester would have had way more pressure dinks in it. And then as far as the wave goes, I definitely noticed a huge difference when there's 3 feet smaller.
So this wave is 30 feet wide and Singapore's wave is 33 feet wide.
That extra 3 feet allows you to generate speed and have more time in between maneuvers and have a lot more like lead up into your maneuvers. But with this, it makes it so all your moves have to be continuous and have to lead into each other. And so that means you have to surf with a lot more flow, which is a good thing because then it teaches you to link all your maneuvers together and surf with more flow and to have kind of like a continuous style surfing. Definitely pretty good, but it's definitely pretty fun.
If you made it this far, thanks for watching. I didn't really do much vlogging,
after I talked about the wave and my boards after the first few surfs. So thank you to Good Surf and City Wave for having me. Super stoked on it. It was an awesome experience. And shout out to everybody out there in Dallas for showing me a good time and giving me a lot of hospitality. I definitely want to go back just to go see those people and surf the wave again.